And we're back with another episode of Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. Last episode, we welcomed Sagani into the group. She's looking for somebody. She's looking for Persak, who supposedly has been reincarnated into another form, and she has to find him. And I noticed that we can level up Kanna. I think you should have survival come up, you know. Survival and athletics will help him out. I'll get to choose a phrase. Decrease one dozen stood against the power of the saint. Decreases the duration of and defends against frightened and terrified effects for allies in the area of effect. Rime and frost follow the footfalls of Karth. Allies leave a hazardous trail of frost wherever they move, hobbling and causing freeze damage to enemies. That's pretty cool. Sure-handed Illa knocked her arrows with speed. Decreases reload time and increases the speed of range attacks for all allies. That's not really that useful because we really just go into melee once that's done. And spells. The fox from the farmer did run and leap. Reduces accuracy of disengagement attacks for enemies in the area of effect. Okay, I like this rhyme and frost one. I can't choose another first level one, so. Done. Well, that's how we select the wolf. I mean, the fox.
Eh?
Okay. I was right, she's a ranger. Sagani draws up beside you, her fox following at her heels, and she takes a seat next to you.
Even if you are putting one over on me, it's nice to have a hunting party again.
Sounds like you've been gone from home a long time.
5 years for me. Must be 30-something for Ichimok.
Hearing its name, the fox looks up. What an adventure.
It certainly started out that way.
She grins warily.
It's been a long hunt. A long time away from my family. Before, I'd crossed the tundra of Nasitok following caribou herds. I didn't want to leave Kalu and our children, but I was eager to visit lands my people rarely do. But 5 years without finding him. It's like 2 hours of necking. I'm ready to be done with it.
Right. Why do you have to find Persak?
Soul recovery is an old village tradition. We call it the Tarnek Ilitsak. Once in a generation, we seek the soul of a much respected and long dead village elder. We tell him what's changed in the village, how people remember him. The only other Tarnek Ilitsak during my lifetime happened when I was a girl, not long after Persak died. We feasted on blubber and fermented milk for a week, and we honored the chosen huntress as a hero. Then she left, and we returned to our duties. We still sang her name to the skies during festival season, but we otherwise didn't speak of her.
What happened to her? I don't think she ever returned. It happens that way sometimes. She folds her arms, her expression sober. I'm sure your village still remembers you, Sagani. You're kind to say so, but I'm not so fragile that I need my name chanted in the meeting halls.
It's not being forgotten by my village that troubles me. But sometimes I wonder how my husband and children remember me, if they think of me often.
That must be difficult.
Still, there's no point in dwelling on it. More often I find myself wondering whether Persak will remember us. You claim to see souls. What do you think? Do you remember your past lives?
No, not clearly. I figured. Most people don't, anyway. I suppose that's why I'm supposed to remind Persak of what he left behind in our village. What would you tell him about your village?
Masuk is probably much the same as it was 100 years ago. We live between tundra and frozen forests, and the land takes as much as it gives. But our hardships bring us together. And the elders truly unite us. They keep the stories of past generations, and they guide us from season to season, through good years and lean.
Itamak brushes against her hip, and she scratches his head. Recently, there've been a lot of good years. My aunts say we've had fewer clashes with neighboring villages thanks to the hunting territories that Persak helped establish. In bad years, we rely on trade with the merchants that pass our shores. We exchange walrus tusks and seal pelts for grains that last us the hard winters. Persak brokered a lot of those arguments, too. She holds up the bear figurine. He got this from one of the Amawa ships that used to trade with us. It sounds like Persak did a lot for your people.
That's what I'm supposed to remind him.
She shoves the Adra bear back into her caribou skin pack. Sounds like you're on a hunt of your own, though. You're feeling the thrill of the chase, or ready for this to be over? It's too early to tell. She nods. Fair enough. She rises and stretches, looking around. Might as well keep moving while we've got some daylight. I'd like to talk some more? What's on your mind? What are your thoughts on my search? She frowns. Helps to know what you're hunting. You've got a lot of tracks to follow, but where they'll lead is anyone's guess. Anyone's guess, huh? You have a family back in your village? Of course. We never send a woman who hasn't the chance to find a mate and have a couple children of her own. Tell me about your children. I've had 5. Yokona, Estuya, Naduo, Anik, and Malak. Estuya and Anik died young in long, lean winters. Malak was barely talking when I left. She scrapes a thumbnail along the handle of her hunting knife. He probably won't know me when I get home. She frowns, her hand falling from the knife. Even in Nasatak, I spent most of my time on the hunt, but then it's easier to relish the hunt when I know I'll see my family enjoying our kill. What's your husband like? Kalu's a good man. He's raised our children well and built us a strong home while I've been away on hunts. Our parents chose us for one another when we were still young. Not the way things are usually done here, but ours chose well. She smiles. We came to appreciate each other as helpmates first, then friends, and then, well, you know how it goes. There's a hint of a blush below the stripe of face paint. She might get mad if we ask her about this thing, so... I'm curious about your search for Persak. I'll tell you what I can, but Tarnik Ilitsak pilgrimages like mine are rare. Why do your people have this tradition? She pulls the bear figurine out of her satchel, running a finger along its smooth back. It's something we've always done. The elders say it was first begun to forge ties with other villages. It's hard to fight over caribou herds when you see someone you respect on the other side. We also believe that passing our history on in this way keeps us stronger, and it helps them, the elders I mean, return to us after they've been away from us for a generation or more. They can use the experiences they've accumulated over lifetimes to lead the village again. Are elders usually reborn so far from the village? Most often they return somewhere in Nasatak, a member of another village. Or they're reborn among the Glamfellen of the White That Wends. Even so, it's hard to say what's usual. A mischievous grin crinkles her eyes. When my grandfather was a boy, the elder came back as a polar bear. The huntress chosen for the task had to recite half of her village deeds while running from the beast. Her expression sobers. Even so, there have been journeys longer than mine. Some last decades, and the huntress doesn't always return. What happens when the elder is found? That depends on the man or woman he's become. It's easiest when the rebirth happens in another village of Nasatak where the tradition is understood. Even in the White That Wins and the southern islands of the Deadfire Archipelago, people understand this custom and will welcome you politely enough, even if their souls do not remember. She shrugs. But sometimes you find someone whose soul has no memory of the village, and you have to tell him of people who remember him still. As disheartening as this is, you hope that the reminder will aid his soul in a future life. How did you get picked to come search for Persak? She grins. Another old village tradition. The elders watch the caribou migrations and cast seal bones to determine the right time for this journey. When the omens were determined, all the village wives drew shark teeth. We're the ones that go away to hunt and fish, so we're best suited for a task like this. Anyway, I grabbed a little tooth. She frowns. Traveling so far is a rare privilege for us, but as you can see, the journey can be unpredictable. What do you do back in Nasatak? I'm a long hunter. I stalk game across the tundra with some of the other wives. We usually hunt caribou and oxen, but we find hares and birds, too. It's a good and respected position to see so much of Nasatak in the company of my friends and sisters. This is one of the pleasures of life in Masuk. Tell me about Itamak. She scratches behind his ear. A good hunter, but not much of a talker, and that's been fine by me. When we hunt in Nasatak, we almost always bring our foxes with us. They help us track and flush game, and they're fearless defenders against bears and snow leopards. Clever Itamak has always been my favorite. He wags his brushy tail. I want to know about your homeland. Nasatak? She rubs her nose with one broad finger. It's a big island in the middle of the Deadfire Archipelago, just off the coast of the White That Wends. Tundra mostly, with a few snow-covered forests in the warmer parts. Most of us live in fairly small villages, by standards here anyway. Mine is Masuk. Tell me more about Masuk. We're a tundra village. To an outsider's eyes, we're probably not much different from the others around us, but our elders have stories that go back hundreds of years. Epic hunts, battles with neighboring villages, sojourns across the sea. We share these stories, too. What's Nasatak like? She shrugs. Cold, but not as cold as the White That Wins. The few Kith who visit Nasatak find it sparse, but there's plenty to sustain a village if you know where to look. She ticks the items off on her calloused fingers. We get hides and meat from caribou, seals, and small whales. Bone, too, which makes us fine bows and arrowheads. Community is important to us. We survive or perish together, so everything we do, every week-long hunt, every wall we build, is for the village. Who lives there? Mostly Inuttenik, like me. People here call us boreal dwarves. Migratory clans of Glamfellen from the White That Wends sometimes spend the colder seasons on Nasatak, but we don't see too many other foreigners who can tolerate the elements. She pats a weather-bronzed arm. Those of us born in Nasatak like to say we have a hardy layer of seal skin just below our beneath our flesh. Well, that's all. Let's move on. Anyone else want to talk while we're at it? No, I don't think so. Okay.
And what does the flame reveal?
I don't know. Let's see. We can't go that way. Can we go around? No. So this is the map. Gotta make our way around all this. Deer cap. Oh, no, another forest lurker. Attack. Yeah.
Yeah.
Brave Zalfilon.
Now, what does she have? This is marked prey. And wounding shot. Let's try the marked prey. Hope he doesn't miss with this. Necrotic Lance.
Believe.
Love. Love. The unseen.
Sweet. He does all the way back here. Wait a second. Who's this? Itumac? Move over there. These guys are all squinched together. He's stuck. I'm looking for Firebrand, but I forgot she left the party. It's too funny. Attack, little doggy. Boxy, boxy. That's right. I keep forgetting, guys. I'm gonna decrease the music a little bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe I can actually hear our characters over the music a little bit better.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
I only noticed it with Sagani, though, that you can't hear her that well over the music. Maybe she's just a very soft-spoken individual. She's tough, though. Tough and soft-spoken. Oh, there's someone dead over there. Dead adventurer, hide armor, a potion of wizard's double, and 26 golden dukes. Sorry, dead adventurer.
Hmm?
Afraid we need that stuff more than you do. Continuing. Hear that? I heard like huge, like something running that was like a giant. And boom, 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 boom. Maybe that's the sound the forest lurker makes. Let's get out here into the open so I can see people. I'm about to be seen. What is it? Wounding shot? All right.
Hey.
Now I can use that. Kinda keeps getting stuck behind people. She's already used her spells up. Oh my god, Durance! Oh, he's out. That's quick.
Yes.
You are attacking, right?
I'm here.
I don't think she was, actually. You were attacking also? What? Is that why we're dying? Our fighters aren't doing anything? It's almost down. They're tough. Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Margrin's fire casts light in dark places.
Sure.
Yes, it tends to do that, yes. And we'll map out the bottom of this and head around. Here's more of the road. Seems like a pretty empty zone compared to places like the Vale Wood and stuff. Barath spell? Is that new? Another forest lurker, holy crap. Let's head over this way. It starts heading in our direction like the last one. Okay. Aloth.
How may I help?
You can move back there. No, we'll fly. We'll go in formation. Fly in formation once we start moving forward to attack with our ranged weapons anyway. Move too far away. Where is it? There it is. Oh well. I'm still gonna be partially obscured by all this foliage, but we only got one arrow off? All the usual tactics. She's still casting. Soul shock.
I'm here.
Nidair is actually healing faster than he's hurt. Although he's hitting Sagani now. It was just grazing him, that's why.
That's it.
And another one down. Maybe we should rest. Let's just rest real quick. Because Durance is messed up. Okay.
Nice and quiet.
Let's clear out this little bit here.
I shall.
Yeah.
We all shall. Head back to the road. Well, I thought we might clear this area, but we got into a big conversation with what's her name? Sagani. I had to remember that name. Orland's Cradle. Either way, we're close, though. Ooh, there's something up there. That's for sure. We will check that out shortly. Oh, another one of those pogres, or whatever how you pronounce it. Oh, she can level up, DS. We'll do that. What helps with perception? I don't know. Lore and survival. Ooh, we got a new spell. A new level spell. Ectopsychic Echo. Gotta love these names. Generates a rebounding wave of psychic feedback between the cipher and an ally that causes crush damage to anyone caught in between. That would require some maneuvering, though, of course. Fractured Volition. Well, I can take two. Violates an enemy's memories to bring vivid recollections of past failures to the surface, leaving the target hobbled and weakened. Pain Link. Mentally links nearby enemies to the target, forcing them to experience a portion of all damage the target suffers. Cool. I like that. Puppet Master. Destroys a target's psychic defenses, leaving them dominated by the cipher for the duration. Sweet. Secret Horrors. Causes enemies in the area of effect to believe their worst fears have been realized, frightening and sickening them for the duration. And Soul Ignition. Forces an enemy's soul to leak energy, igniting the air around them and burning over time. Nice. I think... What's the other one I liked? Pain Link and Secret Horrors. Pain Link, no, and Soul Ignition. New talent unlocks. I'm waiting for this guy. Ooh, really close. She's excellent survival. And pretty good with stealth. Everything else stinks. So I guess our priest is going to be our, you know, unlocker and disarmer of traps, at least for now. So once he levels up, I'll be increasing his... What do you call it? His mechanics. Someone's got to be good at it, you know? Attack!
Hmm?
They're pretty tough, these things. So what do we got? Soul ignition. Try it. Additional effects for 13 and a half seconds.
I'm here.
Ooh, Aloth. How exciting, we can all level up.